Next, we have comparative genomics, and this is when you compare the similarities and differences in the genetic code of different species. It used to be that figuring out a genomic code took millions and millions of dollars, but some of the technology that was developed during the Human Genome Project is now used to make this a much faster process. And it now takes about $7,000 to $8,000 and about 3 weeks to get a complete genome of a particular species. Comparative genomics can answer a lot of interesting questions. Is this species a good model for studying human disease? I'm sure a lot of people have heard that we use mice instead of humans for different kinds of medical studies. Comparative genomics would tell us, well, are there genes similar for studying lung cancer or studying digestive diseases? Maybe there's other models that would work better for different kinds of diseases. We use fruit flies and zebrafish to study genetics, but we can see, are those good models or not? We use yeast to study basic cellular functions. And again, we can see how much from the yeast still applies to humans. Another important question is how closely two species are related. So we can look at genomics to understand the degree of genetic change between different groups, and that can help give us some of our family trees. Genomics can look at why a particular crop is more drought tolerant than another. There's a lot of work in agriculture trying to understand, for example, why this wild species can survive drought where other species can't. If we can identify how the genes are different, maybe we can genetically engineer our crops to be able to be drought tolerant as well. Another question is understanding evolutionary change at molecular levels. So here we're seeing the gene for cytochrome C, which is part of our electron transport chain, and how that has changed over time. All living things have cytochrome C, so it makes a nice comparison. We can even use comparative genomics to figure out what species were in a place even when they're not there anymore. This video will explain DNA barcoding and how that might work.